Hey everybody, welcome back to the workshop. So my last video I was talking about making new door panels. So I started cutting out my door panel material. It's that compressed cardboard, the real heavy stuff. It's almost like plywood. I was trying to get it attached to the original metal piece that hooks to the top of the door. And the way they used to do it was they would use like a stamping machine that would punch holes through the metal, and the punched hole would drive a metal prong on all four sides into the cardboard, and they hold on really well. I can't do that, obviously, because I don't have that machine. So I started messing around with screws. And I started with some sheet metal screws, and they do go through, and they grip the cardboard pretty well, but I don't trust that they'll last, right? Doors take a lot of movement. You know, you slam them, they open and close all the time. And I can just imagine those screws working themselves loose and then pulling out. So I needed to find a nut that would be nice and flat. And I found these, they're called flat nuts or stamp nuts. And I'm using number 6 sized screws, 632s. I started with sheet metal screws. That's what I have on here. And you can see that's pretty long. That's too long. Then I tried, that's a half inch. Then I tried quarter inch. Quarter inches came up too short. They didn't come through far enough to engage the threads on the nut. So then I found some 632 machine screws, 5/16 of an inch long. Those work. So they come through, they protrude a little bit, but not too bad. And I test fitted one of the doors. Let me show you. Okay, so here's the driver's side front door, where I use the method of the screws that I was just talking about. So you can see they do protrude a little bit, and they hit the inside of the door, but I don't think it's bad. I think it'll work for me. I may grind them down a little bit, but they don't seem to interfere too much, so I think I'm good to go there. And you notice I put some sound deadening material on here, and that's because the original door, when I took it off, it had multiple layers of padding, right? So there was a strip of padding that went up against this metal piece, and then another piece of padding that went on top of the metal and over this first layer of padding. And the reason they did that, I think, was to eliminate the bump you get, because there is like a raise here when you transition between the cardboard and the metal. So this sound deadening material that I've been using is the right thickness to pretty much bring it up to the same level. So once I have this all installed on the door, I can put my foam over top, and that should prevent a bump from forming on the foam. And that'll be a nice flat surface for the vinyl to go on. I'll put the vinyl on. So this is coming along nicely. It's really going to clean up the inside of the car compared to the old stuff. I'm doing the fronts, the backs, and then there's some other panels in there as well. So more to come. Thank you.